Welcome to Ask Arcadia, where John Courteney-Smith will be answering your questions.
So just replying to one of your questions about what's the difference between a tungsten and a tungsten halogen lamp and how do they work and why are they good for providing infrared for reptiles. Well, tungsten and tungsten halogen lamps have been available for a long period of time. We have adapted them and changed them and altered them slightly in different ways to make them more usable for reptile keepers, but they're still based on that historic tech that we used to illuminate our houses, shops, offices with. One of the good things about tungsten and tungsten halogen lamps is that they work by passing current through a filament. So they're all classed as filament lamps. And what that does is superheat a filament, generally made from tungsten, which as a byproduct of this superheating also emits a certain amount of light. Because of that process, only a very small percentage of the light that's emitted from a lamp is actually visible. The rest of it is red and infrared A mostly. So how do the different tungsten lamps work? What's suitable for who? What different types are available? And what benefits are they for reptiles? And then how does that compare to halogen lamps? We've put a lot of effort into our halogen lamps recently, and I will show you the difference. So this here is a 50 watt tungsten spot lamp. Now, if you can see on the inside here, you'll see that there is a tungsten filament coil all wound around a cradle. Now, as you pass energy positive and negative through the lamp, it basically shorts out through the coil and the coil will start to glow. The lamp or envelope here has one of the noble gases inside, usually argon, which stabilizes and protects that filament also. Now, this is a spot lamp, so you can see that it has a clear front and an internal aluminiumized reflector inside of the lamp. Now, what's going to happen with that lamp is a percentage of the energy that is produced will be converted into visible light and the rest into infrared and red. And then this will emit through this clear glass in a tight or short beam. So we're coming down like this. And that's a spot lamp. So a great deal of the energy of the lamp is projected straight downwards from the lamp and over a smaller area. So that means that these lamps provide more energy over a small area, therefore that area will be of a higher temperature. One of the negative parts of tungsten lamps of this type is that they're not very well insulated and the reflector is not as thick as you'll see with some other lamps, so there is some wastage. But they are a good form of spot tungsten lamp. Next, we have tungsten floods, and this is generally what most of us should be using. And you'll see that these have got a frosted or an acid etched front here, and what that does is widen the beam. So you have the same amount of light from the filament depending on the wattage of the lamp. However, instead of that energy being concentrated over a small area, you now have a very wide beam. So this will give you a wide beam of energy coming down of a lower temperature or power density, which is something we'll be talking more about later. So you can see we still have the internal reflector, but we have a frosted glass, and this is your flood lamp. Both the spot and the floods are available from wattages between 50, 75, 100 and 150 watts. And you can tailor the use of your lamp to the need of your animal. When we then get to halogen, you'll see we have a completely different type of lamp. These use a very thick envelope, so the glass is very thick and very insulating, and a solid either folded metal or vaporized aluminium reflector on the inside. These capture much more of the energy that's produced by that lamp and reflect it downwards. It's basically much better insulated, less waste. Halogen lamps use a tungsten filament within a halogen gas inside a small capsule within the lamp. And typically they produce more light per watt used than standard tungsten lamps. So they're a more energy efficient solution. They're brighter and they can reach higher temperatures or higher power density readings more quickly. They also tend to be a little bit more robust. So this is our 75 watt PAR 30 halogen lamp, and you can see here that we use a acid etched mid-beam flood lens for these. Now these are very powerful lamps. If this had a clear front, it would be incredibly hot directly beneath the lamp over a very small area. So with this type of lamp, we'd get a mid-beam, which will give you a nice wide spread of light, certainly big enough to cover an animal in a taller enclosure. And we make tungsten halogen lamps of a flood or mid-beam nature in 35 watt, 75 and 100 watt in the PAR 38 size. And the 50 watt lamp is a more of a tight beam, clear fronted lamp. This is the 35 watt PAR 20 halogen. So this is more of a mid-beam kind of lamp. And you can run these harder through your thermostat for most of the illuminative part of the day. Now the benefit with that is, the harder you run tungsten or tungsten halogen lamps, the more bioavailable the spectrum becomes. So the more we dim a lamp, the more the spectrum reverts into red, and the more energy that goes through the lamp, the more the spectrum is within infrared A. So really we should be picking lamps that can run as close to full power for the basking period as we can. And that will increase the bioavailability of the provision of light that you use. So a 35 watt PAR 20 mid-beam lamp can be very useful for most of us. And they, you know, they all work in the same way. It's passing energy through a lamp which shorts through a coil. That coil superheats to produce light and obviously a lot of heat.
If there is a product you'd like us to explore more, please let us know in the comments below.